It's a real challenge for an upper limb amputee to really figure out where to go to get their care. Many facilities in the prosthetic and orthotics field provide care to all different levels of amputees.
Here's your myoelectric arm, and here's your activity-specific arm.
However, there are very few that have specials that just provide care to upper limb patients. At Advanced Arm Dynamics, all we do is take care of upper limb patients. This allows us to have a unique perspective, a perspective that focuses on the challenges of an upper limb amputee.
Could you see yourself wanting to use that hand more quickly?
When we look at all amputations, only about 10% of them are upper limb, and the upper limb patients primarily are trauma-related. We really need to take into consideration the self-image component of losing a hand because it can't be hidden under a pant leg or in a shoe. It's visible. From a functional aspect, the dexterity that a human hand has is very difficult to replace. And we need to take all those things into consideration as we craft the appropriate rehabilitation plan. Most facilities provide just the prosthetics. But patients really need a comprehensive approach that includes case management, therapeutic intervention, really being involved on the R&D side so each patient really has the opportunity to get the most up-to-date technology, the most appropriate technology. We've spent a lot of time on the R&D side of this, so we've approached it from an engineering perspective. And then spend a lot of time on the anatomy and really understand what it means to be in a comfortable prosthesis.
Keep your arm up for a moment.
The expedited fitting process involves fitting a patient on really the first day, and we cast the patient and fit a diagnostic socket and often a series of diagnostic sockets until we have an optimal fit. And then we add componentry and the rest of the prosthesis and fine-tune the electronics. At this point, the patient can begin their therapy. They've already undergone their case management and some social work and some psychological counseling. And so within a couple of days, the patient is in a functional prosthesis and really deep into the rehabilitation process.
So is that a better adjustment or was it better before?
This is a good adjustment. I like it.
We have all of the services under one roof, and they're all dedicated to an individual, a patient, to make sure that they maximize their rehabilitation potential. One of the unique things of Advanced Arm Dynamics is the intellectual capital that all of our practitioners bring together. This intellectual capital is part of a creative approach to patient care. And while we have guidelines of what we're trying to accomplish, we also understand that not every patient fits within a certain box or certain parameters. And our practitioners have the ability to step out of that box and be creative and come up with solutions that others just haven't thought of.
Perfect.
Our show today is all about dealing with the things that life throws at us. We've been talking about disasters, but you're about to meet someone who's experienced his own personal disaster, and today on the show is about to experience something amazing. So this is really technology that's been developed for wounded warriors. There have been a lot of folks who got wounded in Iraq or Afghanistan.
Sure.
And it's now being used by...
this. Now, Matt's the first civilian to be fit with
first
it.
First civilian. That's so cool. That's so cool.
We've made the commitment to travel all over the globe to be involved in research and development. We have relationships in a lot of different countries, and this exposes our practitioners to the latest componentry that's out there, the latest technology, the latest techniques. And the end result is that our patients have access to things that most patients don't ever have access to.